It's my pleasure to be here before you today to present AB 1571. And this is part of the RCFE, which is the Residential Care Facility for the Elderly. That's the acronym. This is part of an overall package. And this, it came to a lot of our attentions. People knew this was an issue, but the case in Castro Valley, the cases in San Diego, and then a case in my district in French Camp brought to light that there were some horrendous things going on with an appalling lack of oversight and regulations. So this bill does two things. One, it creates additional disclosure requirements for the facilities. And two, it establishes an online consumer information system. First, it just requires that applicants will now disclose the names and license numbers of other facilities that are owned and operated, because they can be in different states and nobody here knows about it. This bill will also require the Department of Social Service to deny an application or revoke an application if they know that somebody's knowingly withheld information. And third, Department of Social Service will now cross-check all applicant information with the Department of Public Health to determine if there's been prior issues. And then for the online part, this bill will now, because right now if you can go on the Department of Social Service website to look up a facility, all you see is their license. That's all you see. So this says they have to develop a system. Skilled nursing facilities have systems in place. Residential cares do not. If you go onto the website right now to see the center in Castro Valley or the one in French Camp that was infested with cockroaches and had strong ammonia, you'll still, that one, say active because they're looking at their appeal. So there is no way for a family who's already in a vulnerable situation, having to place somebody they love in somewhere else, there's no way for them to have information. So that's what this does. This will require the department within 5 years to post the licensee's name, address, telephone number, whether they have a special care unit, both aggregate and detailed information on each facility, including complaints filed, number of deficiencies, enforcement actions and fines, and inspection reports and plans of correction. Again, we're giving the department 5 years to do that. We've really enjoyed working with a series of stakeholders on this, and really think it's a very important bill.